So you want to grow your team? Do you want to rank advance with Posh? Are you looking to get a bigger paycheck? Then you've got to grow your team. Hey everybody, I'm Jessica Perrier, Platinum Premier Leader of my team of Poshpreneurs, and today we're going to talk about how to talk to people about joining your team. Our business, direct sales, any kind of sales out there, the job is to grow relationships. The most important part of growing your team is growing your relationships. People are going to make a purchase or decide to join your team or make a change in their life because of their own private reasons, not because of our reasons. Have you ever been in a situation, maybe you went to buy a car or you went to buy a house or I don't know, you were looking at fabric at the local store and the salesperson is telling you all of the reasons that they love that car or they love that house or they love that fabric. And it's not really making sense to you because it has nothing to do with the reason that you're interested. On the flip side, have you ever gone shopping for a car or a house or fabric and the salesperson or the person that's helping you has talked to you about what you're looking for and why you're looking for it? Simon Sinek has a TED talk out there and it talks about a lot of different companies and what they're doing right. And he says, people don't buy what you do, they buy why you do it. And that is an important lesson. And without going all into that lesson, people don't buy what you do, they buy why you do it. So when we're talking to somebody about joining our team, we want to talk about why we Posh. And we also want to listen, right? Because we have two ears and one mouth for one reason, because we want to do more listening than talking. We want to listen to what their reasons are for joining. Why might they want to be part of Posh? Why might they want to purchase our products? And then we can change our language, change our responses to be speaking directly to them. So you're going to start the conversation or start talking about Posh by talking about why you love it. And it's really important that we connect with our why. Why do you Posh? Is it because of how the products have changed your skin? Is it because you love having an extra $20 in your pocket every week? Is it because of the friendships that you've found? Why do you Posh? And if you can't genuinely answer that question, then pause this video and take 5 minutes to really think about why you joined. What were you looking for? And then take another 5 minutes and think about why you stay and what you're currently getting from Posh. Those are two really important pieces of information that you're going to utilize throughout the recruiting process, throughout the relationship building process in your business. So once we've shared a little bit about why we Posh and we've started to listen a little bit about why they might want to Posh or why they might be interested, it's our job to then invite them. What do you mean invite them? Like invite them over for lunch? I mean, we want to invite them into our opportunity. And the way that we do that is by sending them a pink packet. But Jessica, what's a pink packet? Okay, so a pink packet is literally a platter of information. You are serving up a silver platter of information from which they can pick and choose what information they want. You've included your Why Posh story, maybe they don't read it. You've included a recruiting brochure, maybe they just toss it in the garbage right away. It's not up to us to worry about that. It's up to us to provide that silver platter and that opportunity for that person to select the information. Everybody that we send a pink packet to is not going to join our team, but a lot of them are going to place orders. A lot of them are going to host parties, and some of them are going to join our team. A pink packet is really just a glorified sample package. It's a sample package with a catalog, a recruiting brochure, 6 samples, whether they're portal samples or homemade samples, it does not matter, and a printed copy of your Why Posh. Because remember, we need to know our story. We need to know why we're doing what we do. And when we have that in a printed version, we can include that in all of our sample packages. That way, when somebody is sitting at home, curling up on their couch to check out their Posh goodies from their pink packet, they can read your story. Not only have they heard it from you personally, but they're also reading it. And anything, if you know anything about marketing, us as people, as humans, we need to see, read, hear, touch, feel a message 8 to 10 times before it really resonates with us. So just because you've told somebody why you Posh, maybe you've even sent them a video link to your story, you still want to have that written out Why Posh brochure or pamphlet or even just a piece of paper you've printed it out with, a picture of yourself on it, to share with them, because that's gonna reinforce your story and help them to get to know a little bit more about you, right? Here's another sales saying, if you will. People buy from those that they know, like, and trust. People buy from people they know, like, and trust. I have had lots of strangers join my team, but I have a YouTube channel and I share a lot about myself and a lot about my business on my YouTube channel. So that allows somebody to get to know, like, and trust me just by seeing me on video. Anybody that I interact with in person or in a party or out and about while I'm poshing, I get to know, like, and trust them. I get them to know, like, and trust me. It's important in that relationship building process. So remember, people don't buy what you do, they buy why you do it. They buy from people they know, like, and trust. And it's our job to find out their reasons. What is it in their life that they would like to maybe change? Do they want to get out a little more? Do they want to make a little bit more money? Do they want to change their confidence level? Do they want to have more friends? Whatever it is, find out their reasons and really circle back to their reasons anytime that you're having a conversation about Posh. Okay, so once you've started the conversation, once you've invited them into your business with a pink packet, we want to keep the conversation going. And another Platinum Premier, Leah Dalton, she has a fabulous video on YouTube called Watch Your Balls. And she equates having a conversation, whether it's about Posh or about Posh recruiting or whatever, to a tennis match. And you want to send one ball over the net and wait for a response before you send another ball. Because if you just rapid fire information, or what we call word vomit, then it's like you're a pitching machine and you're just firing tennis balls at somebody who is never going to be able to keep up. Oh, you're interested in joining Posh? Well, when you join, you start at a protege, and once you have $1,000 in sales, you hit pink, and when you hit pink, you go to 25% commission, and then you have quick start rewards, and then we have training videos, and then we have these Facebook groups. That is way too much information, and that is going to scare anybody off. You really want to start slowly. Ask open-ended questions and wait for a response or even another question from them before you offer additional information. Hey, Sally, I saw you got my package the other day. I hope that you've dug into it. I'm super excited to hear what you think. Hey, Jessica, yeah, I got my packet. I tried the hand cream and I totally love it. I haven't tried the other products yet, but I have them set aside for my little mini pamper party on Saturday. Awesome. Well, I'm super excited. I know that hand cream is totally my favorite. I will follow up with you on Saturday or Sunday to see what you thought of the rest of it. Remember, people are going to join for their own reasons and also in their own time frame. We might want to rush them to try those products sooner than later, but truthfully, we have to let them do it in their own time, and we have to be there to follow up when they're ready. I like to follow, and I know I'm overloading you guys with information, but I like to follow a 2-2-2 method for follow-up. 2 days after they've received their packet, 2 weeks after, and every 2 months thereafter. Have you ever heard the fortune is in the follow-up? It's totally true. Anytime you see a training video from me, you're going to see me harping on the importance of follow-up. And that's because the majority of salespeople don't follow up more than one time. And you know what? The majority of sales are made in the fourth, fifth, sixth time of follow-up. So the majority of salespeople don't follow up more than one time, but the majority of sales are made in the fourth, fifth, sixth time of follow-up. You know what that means? We've got a small amount of very successful salespeople out there in the world and a large amount of very unsuccessful salespeople in the world. So if you've ever heard somebody say, oh, I tried that business, it didn't work for me. Well, it didn't work for her because she didn't work it. Sorry, not sorry, but this is network marketing. It takes work. And the biggest part of our job is follow-up, follow-up, follow-up. Okay, have I preached enough on that? Now, when you're following up, remember, we don't want to overwhelm them. We don't want to ask more than one question or answer more than one question at a time. But we do want to make sure that we're asking open-ended questions. The more information we can get about somebody's reasoning or even about somebody's objections, the more we're in a position to be able to help them work through those questions. It's not our job to dismiss objections whatsoever, but it is our job to provide information to them to work through them on their own. Here's an example. So my question to you would be, hey, so you loved your hand cream. On a scale of 1 to 10, where are you at with joining? I know we talked about it way back when, but what are you thinking now? Oh, you know, I'm about a 7. Ooh, that's awesome. You're almost a 10. What is it that's holding you back from being a 10? Well, Johnny just started soccer practices, and Mary has dance class, and my husband is not super supportive. Okay, so there, she gave us three answers, but there's really only one objection. Her husband. Girl, the kids and activities, that's giving you that many more people to put Posh on. That's awesome. That's gonna help your business. Now, I can't help you with your hubby, but what's holding him back? What is it that's making him question the idea? Well, I sold this other direct sales company 2 years ago, and I got a lot of pressure to put big orders on my credit card. So I kind of raked up like $2,000 in credit card debt, and he just doesn't want to see me do that again. Girl, you are never going to be asked to place an inventory order. In fact, Posh consultants don't even carry inventory. I mean, if you wanted to, you're allowed to, but we're not asked to do it and we're not expected to do it. So that's certainly not a concern. So that is totally not a concern. Now back to those dance moms. Dance moms love Posh. Really? We don't have to buy any inventory? I thought I had to have a certain amount of sales to stay active. Actually, if I had to have any sales, I myself never would have joined Posh. But really, no, you seriously never have to buy inventory. We do have an activity minimum to remain an active consultant. It's $300 every 6 months, and you're exempt in the months that you join. So, I mean, if you join this month, your first requirement is $300 in sales next year between January and June. And hello, you can probably do that in your sleep. Dance moms. Oh my God, I had no idea. I'm totally gonna talk to Ben tonight when he gets home, and I'm probably gonna join tomorrow. I'm super excited. I am too, I can't wait. Let me know what Ben says, and we'll talk tomorrow. You guys see, that whole conversation spurred from one open-ended question. Where are you at on a scale of 1 to 10? I just love that question so much. Whether it's about hosting a party, joining your team, or even placing an order, where are you at on a scale of 1 to 10? They answer, what can I do to get you to a 10? What is it that's holding you back from being a 10? The more information that we have, you guys, knowledge is power, right? The more information that we have, the more information that we can provide, and then we can get to the end game of, hello, join my team. Okay, I know I've given you a lot of information. This is my last tip. Apply no pressure. People are going to do this for their own reason. They're going to do it in their own time. And we do not want to apply pressure. That is going to turn off way more people than you're ever going to get to say no. So remember, be respectful of their time, their space, their reasonings, and work with them from their point of view, okay? Apply no pressure whatsoever. We're never going to be a success in this business by pressuring people into sales or pressuring people into joining. So remember, follow-up is absolutely your job. It's not easy for anybody to follow up. We're afraid of rejection. But if somebody says no, they're not saying no to me. They're not saying no to you. They're saying no to Posh. And that's okay. And they're not saying no forever. They're saying no for right now. Continue to follow up, continue to build those relationships. When you're following up regularly every 2 months, you want to make sure that you're reaching out with a little non-Posh stuff sometimes. If the last three messages you've sent have been about Posh only and you haven't gotten a response, go scroll through their Facebook newsfeed. Go make a connection. Go reach out and ask them how their little one is doing in their football or dance class. Start a conversation about something other than Posh. Maybe she shared a recipe recently. Reach out and say, hey, did you ever make those pumpkin bars? I saw you shared that recipe and I'm super excited to try them. Keep the conversation going, but remember, you're not just a business person. That person is not just a recruit. You're two people with things in common. So keep the conversation going outside of Posh as well. It's going to make it a lot more genuine and a lot more welcoming when you message about Posh, when you've had conversations about other things as well. So, who's ready to grow their team? Who's ready to make more money? Who's ready to start rank advancing? If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to give me a thumbs up and don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss another Jessica Posh video.